Oh, wait! Oh, hey, oh, hey! Hey!
Justin Brown, alongside my co-host Bailey. We're here with Bethel Sports Network, bringing you another matchup of your Bethel Pilots volleyball team. Tonight they are facing on the Spring Arbor Cougars. Your Pilots are 5-9 now in the Crossroads League, going against the Cougars, who are an unfortunate 0-15 in the Crossroads. And seeing as we are towards the end of the season, the Pilots are 5-9, as I said. This could be a huge win for them to kind of make that conference tournament, but they didn't get here on individual talent. They did it by teamwork. But here are some of those individual stat leaders brought to us by Bailey.
We have Zoe Wolfenbarger, who has had 217 kills this year. Peyton Anderson with 775 assists. Aaron Carlos with 17 aces. Aaron Carlos once again with 362 digs. And Cassandra Williams with 68 blocks.
So yeah, quite impressive statistics on the Bethel side. And as we mentioned, this is a huge game for both teams. The Cougars looking to get their first Crossroads win of the season, and your Pilots looking to improve the record to 6-9 and hopefully getting that bid into the conference tournament. As we go into set number one, Bailey, what do you think the Pilots have to do to kind of take this first set? Because as we've said before in a previous broadcast, whenever they lose the first set, our Pilots are 0-13. So this set is pivotal for the beginning of this game.
Oh, I think they really need to focus on some teamwork right now. You know, they do so well during the first set sometimes, or they don't. And like you said, that, you know, that's the most pivotal part. I know during their last game, they really struggled with digging. So I think they really need to focus on that. And then their serves. So if they have a consistency in their serving and in their digs, I think they'll do pretty well in this first set.
Yeah, you said it. The key word here is probably going to be consistency. We mentioned it before in our previous broadcast. Throughout this whole season, the Pilots have a lot of talent. They're a great team, but what they lack is consistency. They've had moments of brilliance, moments of where their serves have been incredible. They've had solid teamwork. They've been enjoying the game. And then there's moments where they're just kind of off their game. They're very inconsistent, and that's been kind of a theme throughout the whole season, why they've kind of had a pretty average season. They're 5-9. It's not great. Overall, they're 9-18. It's not a terrible statistic on their side, but it's not great. So here we are. We have now number 8, Peyton Anderson, bringing us set number 1 of your Bethel Pilots against the Spring Arbor Cougars. Hit there by number 14 for the Cougars. That's going to be Rebecca Kujat leading us open with a 1-0 lead for the Cougars.
They hit the pole.
They call the pole shot. Yep. There you go. That's going to be 1-0 for the Pilots. Service there from Peyton. Big hit from 13. Unfortunate play there by Katie. She was in the right spot. Just couldn't quite get her hands around that ball. Now service. We have number 15, Gabrielle Hilliard for the Cougars. Tied ball game 1-1 in set number 1. Good hit there from the Bethel side, and that's going to be blocked out of bounds. 2-1 for your Pilots. We now have some subs coming on. That's going to be Cassie Sears and Meg Gabbard coming on to the court for the first time tonight. To service now, we have Meg Gabbard. She's been a pretty consistent server throughout the entire season, so we'll see what she can produce tonight. Pilots up 2-1. Good service from Meg. Touch over the top there, finding the open gap in the Bethel defense. That's going to be tie ball game, 2-2.
Just that consistency. They've got to keep consistent with us.
Service from the libero on the Cougar side. Dig there by Meg. Hit coming from the senior leader, Zoe. Dealt well with by the Cougar side. Set coming. Big hit from number 14. Huge dig there by Gabbard. Going to be over Cassie. Free ball now for the Cougars. Big hit there. Finding the open spot just past the outstretched arm of Gabbard. It's now going to be 3-2 for the Cougars side. And so far, Bailey, it's been pretty even both ways. Nothing really special on either side. Service once again by number 4, Leah Rose. Good service there. Keep it alive. It's now going to be a free ball for the Cougars side. Good block there from the front line of your Pilots. That's going to be into the net there by number 2. That's a huge block there from the Pilots side. The ball game 3-3. We now have Haley Brown in the game for the first time. Cassandra's subbing out.
That's something the Pilots have always been great at, is their blocking and their
Erin Carlos with a serve. As Bailey mentioned, she is the best, at least by statistics, with as far as saves go. She's had the most. Oh, that's unfortunate play there. That's a little mistiming from Haley Brown, a little miscommunication. But, yeah, Erin Carlos has the most aces on the team. She's a solid server. She has been the whole season. That's an unfortunate play there from the – just a little miscommunication. Service now for 12. Taylor Johnston, that's a senior straight out of Spring Harbor, Michigan. Dig by Zoe. Back over the net by Zoe. That's a good hit there from Zoe Wolfenbarger. Now back over the net for Spring Harbor. Three blockers at the net, not enough to deal with for the Spring Harbor Cougars. That's now going to be 5-3. Pilots down by two. Set.
They just need to make sure they're covering those holes on the court. Or, you know, it seems like Spring Harbor has a pretty good eye for finding those holes.
Speaking of finding holes, that's going to be Cassie Sears finding the open spot there. That's a good find there from Cassie Sears. Wasn't the best hit ball, wasn't a whole lot of power, but all it takes is to find an open hole. That's now going to be Pilots only down by one. The senior leader is Zoe Wolfenbarger up for the serve.
She's had great, consistent serves all season.
That's going to be pushed long there from the Cougars side. Now tied ball game 5-5. We mentioned Zoe, one of the seniors. It was senior night last game against Goshen. Unfortunately, they lost 3-1. But the other senior, Amanda Brinkman, is actually out for the rest of the season. She's had some wrist issues throughout the whole season, and she decided that it was too much. She was in too much pain, so she's done for the season, unfortunately, but she did get to play the last game in senior night, so it was a good play there. Good spot there from the Cougars, finally an open spot, just past Meg Gabber once again. Cougars now up by one.
And I see that Haley Brown is no longer taped up, so that's good for her.
That is good, yeah. She's been fighting an injury she's had since last year. So, yeah, to see her not taped up is definitely a good sign there for the pilot side. Peyton Anderson with a huge hit. That's going to be called long by the side judge. Unfortunate play there. Pilots now down by two in set number one. Haley Brown with the hit there. Good return from the Cougar side. It's going to be a free ball now for the Pilots. Set for Cassie Sears. That's going to be touched and out of bounds. Point for your Pilots now down 6-7 as we see Katie Easter and Britton Carnahan coming on for the first time for your Pilots tonight. Katie Easter now up to serve. Pilots down by one in set number one. Kind of an awkward dig there from the Cougar side. Good block there from the blockers up front. Unfortunate play. Katie Easter was there. Couldn't quite get the ball up. Pilots now down by two once again in set number one. Dig by Carlos. Short set there for Haley Brown. That's the second mistimed jump there by number 12. That's an unfortunate play by the Pilots. A little miscommunication. Now Coach Michelle Wiegand call a timeout. Pilots only down 6-9 in set number one. Small mistakes that have kind of gotten to this point. What do they got to do coming out of this timeout to turn things around?
I think the timing is a huge aspect of things, especially with Haley Brown especially. I mean, those two drop balls. So I think just timing and communication again, like you were saying, is going to be huge for them. Getting those digs, I mean, without those, they really are not going to be able to, you know, win this.
Definitely. As we mentioned before in our previous broadcast, typically whoever comes out So we'll see what can happen now with this timeout. See if the Pilots can come out strong. Only down by three. By no means are they out of this set. But we should definitely see that timeout. A little bit of fire, a little bit of energy. Definitely going to be needed in set number one.
Yeah, I'm hoping they'll be able to get their fire back up.
block there from the Cougars,
nice
kept
save.
Alive from the Bethel side. Aaron Carlos was there. Touch there, off the block, set from Zoe. Peyton going over
nice
the top.
Hit.
Good find there from Peyton Anderson. That's a huge pile. It's definitely what they needed out of that timeout. Now for the first time tonight, we have number 11, Bridget Downs, the true freshman coming onto the court now to serve for your Pilots, as the Pilots are down by two and set number one.
You watch plays like that, what just happened, you are amazed sometimes at how, you know, something that seems so sloppy just turns into a point for them.
Short set there for the Cougars. That's going to be a free ball. Somehow kept alive. That's going to be four hits if they're to try to get that over again. That was kind of an awkward play there. That was touched over the top by Zoe. Seemed like it should have been a free point for the Cougars, but that ended up being in favor of the Pilots. Now down by only one. Definitely what they wanted to see coming out of that timeout. Short set there. Zoe with the dig. Peyton's got to go over.
Just need to find those holes.
Zoe with the hit there. By Zoe, she was there, just didn't quite get her hand around the ball. But a pretty good start out of this timeout. Pilots went up 2 points straight out of the timeout, now down by only two.
I think if they keep up what they have going on,
service now by number 9, McKay Heasley. Good touch there over the net by the Pilot side. And we've talked about this a few times in previous broadcasts, is when they can mix it up instead of just doing the big hit every time, where they can kind of mix it up and get that short set over the net, that can be huge for the Bethel Pilots game. And just like that, unfortunate play there from the Pilot side. That's gonna be Peyton Anderson for the service into the net. And it's kind of mistakes like that that they kind of have to avoid. And they keep getting themselves down, they get up a few points, and then they make these small mistakes that kind of shoot themselves in the foot. Unfortunate play there on the Pilot side. Bridget with a hit over there. Somehow that found a way over the net onto the court of the Pilot side. Cougars now up by three in set number one. We have number 15, Gabrielle Hilliard, once again up to serve. Dig by Zoe. Zoe with the hit. That's going to be into the net. Touch, though. No touch by the Cougar side. At first, it was touched by the blockers, and then the judges called it a fourth hit from the Pilots. Now, Pilots down by four, the gap increasing quite a bit. Service again by number 15. Miss hit there. That's got to go over the net. That's going to be a free ball now for the Cougars. Over the top there, Cassandra with the block, but not enough. Pilots now down by five. Coach Wiegand will call another timeout. A little frustration now on the Pilot side as they are down by five. They held them within two, and they kind of gave away a few points. Now it's a 5-1 run for the Cougar side. Yeah, definitely consistency is going to be the key once again for the Pilot side. They've got a lot of talent. They just have to be consistent. They can't give away those free points. They can't give the Cougars any points at all. They're going to have to earn every single point. So that's kind of an unfortunate last few plays for the Pilots. But once again, we're going to have number 15, Gabrielle Hilliard, the junior out of Waterford, Michigan, up to serve again. She's had about four or five serves in a row, doing very well. Pilots defense has to come up huge now to turn this thing around. Dig from Zoe, a little miss hit there. That's going to be a free ball now for the Cougars. Big hit there over the top. Katie Easter was there. Frustration, though, on the face of the Pilots once again as Katie was there. It was just a little bit of a miss hit. Dig from Katie. Short set there for Cassandra, pushing along, kept alive by the Cougar side. Hit over the top there. Katie Easter there with the set. That's an unfortunate play. Once again, another minor mistake from the pilot side, leading to another Cougar point. It's now a 6-0 run for the Cougars. Short service, Cassandra with the dig. Zoe's got to go over. Trying to find the hole, unfortunately pushes it wide. Not what the pilots wanted to see coming out of that timeout. Cassandra Williams with a huge hit there. That's definitely what the pilots needed to kind of get out of that rut. Good set there by Peyton Anderson, and a good hit there from Cassandra finding the open spot. Now back on the court, we have Meg Gabbard and Cassie Sears. Pilots down by a significant 7 points. They just got to chip away at that lead. Short service there by Meg. It's going to be a double hit called against Spring Arbor. 2 points in a row now for your Bethel Pilots. The lead within 6 points. Another great service there from Meg Gabbard. Dig from Carlos. Backcourt set, unfortunate. That's going to be into the pole. Point once again. That's actually going to be a net violation called against Zoe. That is a point now for the Cougars. Pilots had a little bit of a run. Unfortunate now. They're still down by 7. That's going to be service into the net. Service error for number 4 on the Spring Arbor side. Erin Carlos now to serve. We mentioned she does have the most aces on the team. See what she can do now here on the service. Good service from Carlos. That's not going to be a free point. Free ball for the pilot side. Zoe's got to go over. Found that short-sided spot in the court. That's going to be a point for your pilots now within 5 points. Another great service from Carlos, just finding a spot over the net. Blocker is coming in huge there from Cassie and Haley. Now it's going to be, ooh, into the net there from Spring Arbor. Pilots feeling it. A little bit of momentum on their side as they had 3 consecutive points. Exactly what they needed in this set number 1. Service from Carlos, another good serve. That's going to find the back corner. Carlos was there, decided to let it go. That's now going to be 5 points. Spring Arbor is up to serve now. We have number 12, Taylor Johnston, the senior out of Spring Arbor, Michigan. Played by Carlos. That is going to be a double hit called against the senior, Zoe Wolfenbarger. Pilots now down by 6. Spring Arbor within 5 points of taking set number 1. Another service. Dig by Gabbard. Short set for Haley Brown. Job well done there by the blockers on the Spring Arbor side. Dig once again by Gabbard. Set there for Peyton. Cassie Sears. Huge hit from Cassie. That's going to be off the ceiling. A little home court advantage there on the pilot side. Point for your pilots. We now have Zoe Wolfenbarger, or Vegas as they call her, up to serve. Only down by 5 points. See what they can do here now in set number 1. Finding a way through the blockers is going to be number 8, Alyssa Walker, the freshman out of Indianapolis for Spring Arbor. Now up by 6, only 4 points. That actually, what was the call there, Bailey? I missed it. That's going to be a point for the pilots. Could be a net violation call there. Either way, point for the pilots. Now down by 4. Zoe with a great service there. Right over the net. That's going to be a timeout now called for Spring Arbor, and the pilots doing very well toward the end of the set, number one, having a string of few points together, doing very well defensively, some solid serves out of the senior, Zoe Wolfenbarger. Now, Bailey, what do the Cougars have to do out of this timeout to kind of set things up? Yeah, definitely. I think the digs for the Cougars defensively is going to have to step up a little bit. There's been some solid serves, some solid kills on the Pilots side. And for the Pilots, they just got to keep this momentum a little bit. They're having some fun. They're enjoying the game. They're doing very well so far as a team. A few blunders, but nothing too crazy. So we'll see now what Zoe can do. One of the more solid servers for the Pilots side. They got to string some points together now. Keep this streak alive. See what can happen in set number one as we are near the end of this first set. Touch there from the blockers. Aaron kept it alive. It's going to be over now for Peyton. Good job there from the Pilot side. Good block there from Haley and Cassie. That's huge for the Pilots as they're now only within 2 points of the Cougars. Zoe once again up to serve. Good service from Zoe. Haley and Peyton there with the block. Zoe with the set. Cassie Sears over the net. Good dig there from the Cougars side. Unfortunately, that's going to be a Pilot's point. But the senior there, Taylor Johnston, coming up huge there with the dig. Unable to pop it up enough for her teammates. Pilots now only down by one in set number one. We mentioned the first set is critical for the Pilots as they are 0-13 when they lose the first set. Not the stat they want to see, but if they get this first set win, that would be huge for the momentum. Short set over there, but read well by Peyton. Cassie Sears is going to go over the net. Short set once again. Zoe Wolfenbarger there, Aaron with the set. Peyton with the huge hit, though, pushed just a bit long. Appeals for a touch from the coaching staff on the Pilot side. Not going to get it. Substitute now for Spring Arbor, number 13, Maggie Watson, the true freshman out of Mishawaka, Indiana, a local. Onto the court now for Spring Arbor, service from number 10, Monica Stoats, sophomore. That's unfortunate there for the Pilot side. That's going to be touched and out of bounds. Cougars now up by three and only 3 points away from taking set number one. That's going to have to be over now for Cassie Sears. Short touch there. Cougars had to deal with it. Good block there once again from Haley Brown. She is everywhere tonight. That's huge from Haley Brown. Service now from Katie Easter. Good service from Easter. Short set over the net. Aaron Carlos not able to deal with it there. That's unfortunate for the Pilot side. Cougars now within 2 points of taking set number one. Number two here, Casey Fullis, the sophomore, up to serve. Short set there for Haley Brown. Finding that open hole in the defense. That's a huge point there from Haley Brown as we have number 11 back on. That's going to be Bridget Downs, the true freshman, and Cassandra Williams back onto the court. Bridget up to serve. Pilots only down by two. Huge block from Cassandra Williams. That's awesome. Out of Williams coming on, getting a huge block for her team. Pilots now within one. Bridget up to serve once again. That's a huge hit there. That's going to be touched and up again once from Katie Easter. Good block there from the Cougars side. Unfortunate play A little bit of miscommunication from the pilot side. Subs coming on for both sides. A little bit of a substitution error. Trying to get those subs marked down. Judge slowing things up a little bit, but the subs able to come on and come off. The Cougars now within 1 point of taking set number one. Pilots got a string together, a solid four to win this game. That's going to be out of bounds. Appeals for a touch, not going to get it. That's going to end set number one. Your Pilots fall 25-22 to the Spring Arbor Cougars. Bailey, what happened in that first set? Why couldn't the Pilots quite pull off that win? I definitely agree with that one. It seems like the Pilots just couldn't quite string together the kills and the digs they needed in the right moments. They had some solid points. It just seems like when they needed them most, they couldn't quite pull it off. Unfortunate for the Pilots side, we mentioned that stat once again. They're 0-13 when they lose the first set. Tonight could be the night where they get that one win. It's very doable. It's not like Spring Arbor is, it's not like they've outmatched them. It's just they've got the right points at the right time for the Spring Arbor side. Pilots have got some solid kills, some solid points together, and they've had some momentum on their side. It's just kind of unfortunate that when they needed those key points, they just haven't been able to do it there for the Pilots. So unfortunate first set there, but there's still smiles over there. They're still enjoying the game. It's never fun to lose the first set, but they can definitely turn it around in set number two. Sport, but specifically with volleyball, it's so much of it depends on the momentum. And yeah, if they come out of this brief intermission, this kind of 4 minute time, if they come out of this really flat and not enjoying it, and that's going to be contagious. It's going to spread to the rest of the team. They're not going to be doing very well in set number two. So they got to come up huge now, set number two, kind of have some momentum, have a little bit of pride. This is their home gymnasium. They've only got one more home game left of the season. They don't have an incredible home record. They're 2-10 at home. That's not what you want to see when you're playing your own home court, your own home court advantage. So we'll see if they can kind of turn something around in set number two. Whereas on the Cougars side, they've got some confidence. They're upset. They're up number one set. They've won. They've definitely played pretty well. There hasn't really been anything spectacular out of the Cougars side. And
they're
just one of the yeah, but they've been
consistent.
That's very true. Yeah, they've been consistent. It hasn't been anything crazy. You just need that consistent all your players. And Spring Arbor definitely did that better in set number one. Once again, we'll see what can happen now as we enter set number two. Pilots are down in the set count, 1-0. We'll see what can happen now as we get this started.
Once they keep their momentum up and, you know, they fix those couple little things, I think they'll do really well.
Judge is checking some substitutions real quick, making sure that there are legal players on the court. Service is now going to be for Spring Arbor in set number two. We have number 15, Gabrielle Hilliard, the junior out of Waterford, Michigan, to get things started. Set number two. Dig there from Katie. Good hit there from Bridget. Kept alive by Bridget. Good block from the Spring Arbor side. That's going to be over the net from Cassandra.
Great free ball right there.
That was a cheeky play there from Cassie. Well done. Cougars expecting the third hit. She decides to go right over the net. Not ready for it. That's going to be your Pilots up 1-0 in set number two.
That's a great way to start off the second set right there. Good play, good momentum.
Meg Gabbard now with the serve. That's going to go right over the blockers. Meg Gabbard was there. She's frustrated. She knows that ball was hers. It was just a little out of her reach. Unfortunate play from Gabbard. Now tied ball game, 1-1 service from the Spring Arbor Cougars. Just over the net, kept alive there. Frustration from Gabbard. She knew she had it just a little bit late there. That's a great serve from Leah Rose, the junior out of Pierce, Cathcart, Michigan. Another good serve over the net. Short set there for Cassandra. Good block from Spring Arbor over the net. Peyton keeps it alive. Zoe's got to go over. Touch over the net, finds the gap in the defense. That's going to be Point Cougars. They're now up 3-1. Leah Rose up to serve once again.
Pilots really need to just start covering all their bases, covering those goals, because that's where they're aiming every time.
Jason Gabbard, going to be a back hit there from Cassie Sears. Pushed way long for the Pilots. Pilots now down 4-1. Not the start they wanted to see. Coach Wiegand definitely frustrated as the Lady Pilots are struggling in set number two. That's going to be a point for the Cougars. Substitute now as we have number 11, Bridget Downs, back on the court. Cougars. Pilots now down by five. That's a timeout from Coach Wiegand. That is not the start they wanted. They won that first point, and then it's been Cougars since with a 6-0 run. Yeah, definitely. Pilots got to be able to predict a little bit better what their server is going to be doing. But really, it hasn't been anything crazy. It's just been some miscues, some miscommunication, lack of consistency. We keep going back to that word of consistency. So it's unfortunate for the Pilots side. There's definitely frustration over there with the Pilots. You can see it on their faces. They're not really enjoying it right now. There's frustration. There's a little bit concerned, you can see on the coach's face. They're down by five. By no means are they out of the set. By no means are they out of this game, but they've already dug themselves a hole by losing the first set. Now it's in set number two, and they're down by 5 points. They got to start stringing some points together to get back in this set. It's going to be, once again, Leah Rose to serve for the Cougars. Pilots taking every second they can out of this timeout. Coach Wiegand's got to fire him up, get him going. They got to do something differently to get this, to get back in this game.
You know, we keep that's what they need to work on right now.
Good service once again from Leah. Short set there. Cassandra with a big hit. Good dig there by Gabrielle Hilliard. Giving it over the net now. Cassie Sears with a hit, touched wide. Huge hit there, good dig by Bridget. Unfortunately, that's gonna be in the net and a point for the Cougars. The Pilots had a little bit of life there, stringing together a couple good hits. They did well on that point. Unfortunately, it just went the Cougars' way. That's gonna be a net violation on the Pilots. Once again, a small mistake, but a costly one. That's going to be a point for the Cougars. Pilots down 8-1 in set number two in the series. The Cougars lead it 1-0. Cassie over the net. That's going to be a short set. Three blockers at the line. That's good recognition there from the Cougar side, able to put that just over the net, finding the open gap in the defense. This Spring Arbor team is not playing like they are 0-15 in the conference. They've been done very well so far against this Pilots defense. That's going to be a touch over the net from Peyton. She loves that short touch over there. That's going to be another short touch from the Cougars side, but not enough from the Pilots defense. That's going to be another Bethel College timeout, as they did not get a single point since the last timeout. They gave Spring Arbor 4. Spring Arbor is up 10-1 in set number 2, and it is all smiles on that Spring Arbor bench. They're having a lot of fun. They're enjoying it. They're dancing during this timeout, whereas on the Bethel side, there's frustration. Erin Carlos is trying to get him going. She's trying to give a little speech there, get him pumped up, because the Pilots got to do something differently. They just, whatever they're doing is not working so far for them in set number 2. Probably can hear we have the Bethel College drum line for the first time in Goodman Gymnasium here. It is a recent addition, last year being the first year that the drum line has been on campus. So it's fun they can come out and make a little racket there in the old gym. They're having a lot of fun too over there with the drum line. But yeah, it's been cool to see them at some other sporting events. They've come to a couple soccer games, some rugby games. It's been cool hearing them practice on campus, just kind of mixing things up. Unfortunately, it's not really helping us out right now as we are down 10-1 in set number 2. The music, it would be nice if we could lift them up a little bit. That's going to be... It was a service error by Leah, but the Pilots did something illegal on their side. Bailey, you have any guess on that? I'm not seeing any call by the judge. I don't know what that was. Whatever it wasn't good for the Pilots side. That's a point for the Cougars. Don't do that again, Pilots. Come on. Set for Peyton. Zoe Wolfenbarger, the senior. Good hit there. Finally a break. That's a double hit. Doesn't matter how they got the point. The Pilots just needed a point, seeing as it was an 11-0 run for the Cougars. Not what the Pilots needed. Now 11-2, Erin Carlos with a great serve. That's a great dig there from the senior. Good block there from Zoe and Haley. Good touch from Peyton. That's going to be into the net. Haley Brown lost it. Unfortunate there. Peyton Anderson hit it up, but Haley Brown couldn't find the ball in time. That was a great dig there by Taylor Johnston, the senior for Spring Arbor. Being able to dive in that corner, keep that alive. Good point there from the Cougar side. Pilots able to get 1 point, but unfortunately, the ball goes right back into that Cougar side. Cassie Sears with a solid hit. Good dig there from the Cougar side. Zoe with the booming hit right out of the outstretched arms of McKay Easley, the sophomore for the Cougars. That's another point for the Pilots. Zoe up to serve. The Pilots need her to come up huge now in set number 2. Good block there from Peyton. Unfortunately, that was out of bounds. Blockers were there, just hit it a little bit wide. Unfortunate play for the Pilots. Going to be service for the Cougars. Take from Carlos. Haley Brown with the huge hit, kept alive somehow by the Spring Arbor side. That's a short set over the top from Peyton Anderson. That's the hit we like to see. She's done that all season, and she hasn't done it enough tonight. That's huge for the Pilots. That's what she's comfortable with for sure, as the Pilots are now down by 9 points in set number two, Katie Easter with the service. Dig from Zoe. And that's going to be a double hit, I believe, called against the Pilots. Once again, that's a free point for the Cougars. We mentioned at the beginning of the game, the Pilots cannot keep giving free points to the Cougars. If any point is going to be given to the Cougars, they got to earn it. And it seems like over and over again, they've just been giving away these free points. We'll see what can happen now. Pilots got to turn things around. Good hit there from Zoe. Kept alive somehow by the Spring Arbor side. That's going to be four hits. McKay Heasley, though, diving, keeping that one up. That was incredible from her. Not enough, though. Point Pilots. Down by nine. Once again, Haley Brown up to serve. Good service from Haley. Well done there from the front line of Bethel. That's going to be a block, but pushed out of bounds from the Cougars. Couple of points strung along now for the Pilots. They're only down by eight. Not out of the game. Haley Brown has to be solid with the old serves. We'll see what they can do on defense as well on the Pilots side. Great service from Haley just over that net. And that's going to find the back corner. You saw it on Zoe's face there. She was laid out that you can do about that. That's just a good spot. That's a great play from Spring Arbor. Senior Taylor Johnston up to serve. Spring Arbor is up by 9 points. Katie Easter with a little bit of a miss hit there. Some lack of communication once again on the Pilot side. Not what you want to see for your Pilots. Down by 10. Set number two there, and losing the series 1-0 now in this game. Katie Easter with the dig. Touch over the top from Cassandra. And that's going to be a net violation against the Pilots. That's another free point given to Spring Arbor. The Pilots' bench is dead right now. There is nothing coming from that bench. That's unfortunate. It's kind of hard to, though, right now. There's no momentum on the Pilots' side. Lack of communication. They're giving away these free points. And it has been all Cougars in the second set now. Pilots not able to string anything along. The most they've had is 2 points in a row. And then they just keep giving it back to the Cougars. Got to give some credit, though, to the Cougars. They've played well so far. It hasn't been all the Pilots' mistakes. Cougars have been very solid. Touch over the top there from Peyton. Cougars are ready for it. That's going to be a point now for Peyton Anderson, finding that open gap, getting that touch over the net. Not a huge hit there, but a point they definitely needed. Pilots are down by 11 points in set number two now, as we are going to clean up a little bit of moisture on the court. Don't want anybody slipping. Brief pause, give the girls a little breather. Service from Peyton. That's going to be a double hit called against the Cougars. Point for the Pilots. Pilots got to come together now. A couple points in a row, but it's not enough. They got to get more than that. Spring Arbor only within seven of going up 2-0 in the series. Peyton with a short serve. Huge hit there from number 14, Rebecca Kujat, the senior out of Flushing, Michigan. That was a huge hit. The Pilots were in the right spot, but not able to deal with it. Service now from the Cougars. Huge hit there from number five, Britton Carnahan, that's definitely the point the Pilots needed. Now within 10, Britton's going to come out. No. Number 11, Bridget's coming on, and number 4, Cassie Sears. Little miscommunication now, not sure what they're doing on the old subs. Bridget's coming out, and Nikita Easter is coming out. Sorry, Bridget is coming in, and Britton is coming out. We now have Bridget up to serve, number 11. Pilots now within 10 points. Bridget with a short serve. That's going to be into the net. Service error for the Pilots. That's an unfortunate play there, as now number 2, Casey Fullis, sophomore out of Camden, Michigan, on for the Cougars. We now have Leah Rose once again up to serve. She's been very solid and very consistent all night. That's going to be a miss hit there. Point for the Cougars. And once again, it's been all Cougars in set number 2. Cougars now within 4 points of taking the series up 2-0. Dig from Carlos. Seth Manderson. Cassie Sears with a huge hit. Good dig there out of Johnston. That's a huge hit once again from number 14, Rebecca Kujat. Blockers are there. That's blocked out of bounds. That's a point for the Cougars. Kujat's been huge so far tonight with a few solid kills. Really coming down hard on the ball. Lee Rose up to serve once again. Rochelle Wiegand talking with the judge on the sideline right now. Not sure what they're talking about. Seems as though Rochelle Wiegand, not sure what's going on. Zoe Wolfbarger looks to be a little bit upset. Not sure what the reasoning is behind that. I don't know if she got hit. But there's definitely some confusion between the judges and Coach Wiegand. Pilots are down now by 13. Set number 2 in the series. They're down 1-0. If the Cougars keep up their impressive play so far, they'll be their first Crossroads League win of the season, pushing them to 1-15, and that would drop the Pilots down to 5-10. Pilots have got to come up huge, though. They are currently in 8th place in the league, and I believe the top 8 make it in the tournament. So they gotta win this game and hope that St. Francis doesn't do well. St. Francis is in that number 9 position. Zoe's now going to come out. She's going with the trainer. I believe she was hit. Possibly a head injury of some sort. We'll see what can happen now as a sub is coming in. That's going to be Katie Easter. Cougars within 3 of taking set number 2. Pilots losing their senior leader, Zoe Wolfmarger. That's kind of a huge hit there from the pilot side. Service once again from Leah. Touch over the top there from Sandra, kept alive by the Cougars somehow. Cassius Sears over the net, finding the open gap in the defense. That's a point for your Pilots. Definitely a point that they so desperately needed. Pilots now within 12. Aaron Carlos, as we mentioned, has the most aces on the team. We need to come up huge now for the serves. Touch over the top from number 2, but that's going to be a net violation against your Pilots. And once again, it's been all Cougars. Cougars have had very minimal mistakes so far. They've been very consistent. Whereas your Pilots have been making a bunch of small mistakes. Nothing huge so far, but it's just been plenty of small mistakes that have led up to this dominating performance from the Spring Arbor side. Short serve. Great dig there out of the cut, Cougar side. Touch over the top, free ball now coming for the Pilots. Push long there from Haley Brown. That's going to find the back corner. That's a point for your Pilots. They are now down 11-23. That's going to be a missed point on the scoreboard. It says 10-24, but it's actually 11-23. Good block there from the Pilots front line. This would be a huge point for the Pilots. That's a mistimed jump. That's unfortunate. It's going to be 11-23. Confusion. That was a missed call. It's only 11-24. The set should not be over. We'll see if they can sort things out. Set is not over. They're going to try and call the teams back onto the court. It should only be 11-24 as the 2 points ago was given to a point to the Cougars and not to the Pilots. Set should not be over yet. We'll see if we can get the Pilots back onto the court. Maybe somehow the Pilots can pull this one out and get a win for set number two. It's not looking very hopeful, but here come the Pilots back from the locker room. As it is 11-24, Spring Arbor with a dominating performance so far in set number two in the entire game, really. Mishap there on the scoreboard. But now Spring Arbor has to get 1 point, and we will do this all over again. Teams will go into the locker room, see if they can figure things out. But it is 11-24, Spring Arbor on top the entire game. Other than that first point, the Pilots went up 1-0, and then it was all Spring Arbor since then. See if the Pilots' defense can come up huge now. Big hit from Peyton. Good dig there from Leah. Over the net. Peyton's got to go over. Short set. Now free ball for the Cougars. Good block there out of Cassie and Haley. That front line duo have had a few blocks tonight. I believe it's been 3 or 4. They've been very solid up front. And that's one thing this season that the Pilots have struggled with defensively is in their blocking. And they've done very well so far tonight in blocking the kills from Spring Arbor. Now Cassie Sears up to serve. Down by 12 in set number two. That's going to be a short set over the net. Point for the Cougars. That's set number two. We're going to take it now into a intermission as your Pilots fall 2-0 in the series. We do play to 5. If the Pilots are not able to come back around, then they will go down 3-0. Game will be over. We now have 10-minute intermission. We'll see what we can do in the locker room, see what the coaches can do, get their team going, kind of turn things around. It's been all Spring Arbor so far in this game. They played very well in the first couple of sets. Some stats now from set number one. There are 12 kills from the Spring Arbor side. Casey Hollis leading the team with 5 kills, an impressive 5 kills. And Annika and Maggie each with 2 kills apiece. And then Courtney Kaiser, Rebecca Kujat, and Alyssa Walker with 1 kill apiece. On the Bethel side, we have Cassie Sears with 4 kills, Cassandra Williams with 2, and then Britt, Peyton, and Haley, and Zoe all with 1 kill apiece. And Bailey mentioned it before, Zoe Wolfenbarger does lead the team in kills, but she's only had 1 kill in set number one. I'm not sure how many she got in set number two, but we'll see if she can kind of turn things around, kind of step it up. We did see her go into the training room, I believe with some sort of head injury. She did not look very well, so we'll see what can happen there as we enter into this intermission. Next week, the Bethel Sports Network will begin coverage of Bethel basketball. The women are playing tonight at Holy Cross. They will have their first home game next Tuesday against St. Francis. The women have a new coach this year. That's going to be Eric Gingrich, and he talked about his team a couple weeks ago during Media Day. Here's what he had to say.
Excited about, to this point, the group we've inherited, and we've been really pleased with our progress to this point. So wanted to first thank people for having confidence in us to bring us here to be a part of this endeavor. We've got a couple of my local players here who are also going to play key roles. So I'll just start with them because it's really about them. Madison Schrock, I've asked her to join us today. She's from Northridge High School, local product that Greg, you should know a lot about.
After lunch, of course.
Yeah, a few times. We're grateful, even though that happened a few years ago, that she decided to make the transition and transfer from Division I Bowling Green here to Bethel. She's put in a lot of hard work this summer and is going to be a really key piece for us, not only on the court but off the court too. So we're excited for the work she's put in already, and what she's going to give to us this year as a scorer and as a leader. And then Caitlin L. Sasser's from town here, went to Mishawaka High School. Again, gonna play a key role for us, but wanted to have her here as a local presence so that local media could see the products that you guys have produced here in the area. They're doing great things here at Bethel, and we want to highlight that. So excited for Caitlin and her progress. She's been coming off out of an injury, and she's been working her tail off. So we're excited about that and getting her back to 100%. And we need her back at 100% because anybody that can look down our roster sees, first thing, that we are guard-oriented. We don't have a lot of depth at the post position, so she'll be a key cog for us in that rotation. But we're going to have to play a lot bigger than we look physically. Our players are learning to develop some mental pieces in those areas of playing up, guarding up. And we're feeling more and more confident every day that we're going to be able to make the grind through this conference that it's going to take to get us back up towards the top. So looking through our schedule, we really honestly are just trying to prepare for October 26th against Holy Cross here in town. We open our season up there and hope to have some local fans come support us and some of our local players there. But right now we're just trying to take a small step every day and prep for that game. As we look down, we've got a great non-conference schedule. 9 of our 12 non-conference games are on the road, which is important for us because we struggled on the road last year and we got to learn how to win on the road. So we'll be tested early and often on the road. We have a couple of classics we go to, one in Michigan over Christmas break at Davenport, and we'll play some great competition there. It'll be a great test for us to see if we're ready to for the gauntlet that is the Crossroads League. And then again in Kentucky, we go to Union and we play there against them and Milligan, two really fantastic programs that have done things the right way for a long time, and we'll be tested down there. So we'll be able to have a couple gauges as we go along this non-conference schedule to see where we're at, what we need to improve on. Overall, like I mentioned, we're taking small steps every day. We're really excited about the way this group is coming together as a team. Philosophically, we believe you can't really be that great on the court if you're not a family. And I think we've taken some great strides with our players to do just that.
And we'll see what they can do tonight with that. We will also, he mentioned Caitlin L. Sasser is going to be one of their huge players for the team. She is coming off an injury, and we'll see if she can recover from that in the way that she needs to. They also talked about their non-conference on-the-road schedule. 9 of 12 games are going to be not home, and they said he kind of struggled last year in those away games, so we'll see what the Pilots can do with those away games. And the biggest thing that I noticed when he in that interview was he talked about family, and he talked about what the team has been doing so far to kind of bring them together as a family, and that's huge, really, in any sport. You'll see whether it is volleyball or basketball or any other sport there is here in collegiate sports. If your team is not a family off the court and on the court, then you won't see progress. So that's really true with any team. If there's not cohesiveness, if they don't get along well together, if they don't play well together, then obviously you're not going to get the results that you want. So that's been kind of cool seeing Gingrich come in and that be such a priority. I've heard from plenty of the players that they've enjoyed him so far as a coach. So we see now that the Cougars have come out of the intermission. It's short time in the locker room. They're up 2-0 in a very comfortable position. When the Pilots are trailing 2-0, they're 0-12 in the season, so it's not looking too great for them statistically. But tonight could be the night where they turn that around. The Pilots are still in the locker room. I'm sure Coach Wiegand is trying to fire them up a little bit, remind them that this is their home court, see if they can change things around. Pilots are back on the court, and Amanda Brinkman is actually dressing tonight. We mentioned a little bit before she was thought she was done for the season because of a wrist injury, and you see now that she is dressed and she's ready to go. So we'll see if she can get a little bit of action tonight. She could be that player that the Pilots need to turn things around, get a little fire. I do not see Zoe yet back onto the court. She struggled earlier in the middle of set number two with, I believe, a head injury. No update yet on her. We'll see how she's doing, though. We do have some stats coming in from set number two in the kills category for Spring Arbor. You have Rebecca Kujat. She was huge there with 5 kills. Casey Follis with 4. And then Courtney Kaiser has 2. Alyssa Walker had 1 set. So that was all 12 kills coming out of there. We mentioned Zoe Wolfenbarger is such a huge part of the team, leading the team in kills. She only had 1 kill in set number 2 and 1 kill in set number 1, and now she is out of the game. So it's definitely not what the Pilots wanted to see out of Zoe Wolfenbarger. So we'll see now what they can do without that senior leader, as Amanda Brinkman is going to be on the court. The other senior for the Pilots, she was not expected to play tonight, but she's coming out. See what she can do now for the Pilots team. Maybe that's exactly what they needed to turn this game around, as the Pilots are down 2-0. If they lose set number 3, this is all over, folks. We are going home. So we will see if the Pilots can come out of this one, turn this thing around, win a couple points at a time, and really get the momentum they need for this set number 3. Just under a minute now before we get this thing started. Both teams are now on the court and ready to play, but they're going to let this clock wind all the way down, give everyone the break that they are allowed. Once again, Leah Jones subbing on for the Cougars. She has been very solid tonight so far, especially in the serving category. She's done very well. We have Erin Carlos back onto the court for your Pilot. She's also done very well. Liberos on both sides being very consistent so far tonight. Service now coming from Peyton Anderson. Number 8. To open up set number 3, Pilots have got to come up huge, turn this thing around as we get action started. Dig for there from Anderson. Carlos with the set. Brinkman onto the court. It seems like she is only going to use her left arm there. Unfortunate play there. Gabbard was there. It seems like Brinkman with that wrist or elbow injury, she's going to favor that left arm and only use that to get it over the net. Service now from number 15. That's going to be Gabrielle Hilliard. Short set there for Cassandra. That's a huge hit, but an even bigger block. It's now got to go over the net there for Britton. Cassandra with the touch over the net. That's a point the Pilots needed. Tie ball game, 1-2-1. Onto the court now, we have Bridget Downs and Cassie Sears. Bridget, once again, the true freshman up to serve. See if she can do something now as the Pilots have got to string a few points along. As I mentioned before, this is set number 3. Pilots are down 2-0. Good service there from Bridget. Short set over the top. Peyton Anderson dealt with it well. Cassie Sears has got to go over the net. Free ball now for the Cougars. That's going to be called out of bounds. Appeal for a touch from the Cougars side. Not going to get it. Pilots goes up 2-1. Bridget with another serve. That's going to be a block from Brinkman, pushed out of bounds. Point for the Cougars. And we mentioned Leah Rose has been very, very solid all night. Up to serve now for the visiting Spring Arbor Cougars. Dig by Bridget over the top. That's going to be a free ball for number 2, Casey Follis. That's an easy point. Little miss timing there out of Bridget. That's unfortunate. We mentioned all night these small mistakes that the Pilots have been making and they can't keep doing. That's a service once again from Leah. Cassie's going over. Huge hit there. Dig by Bridget, but not enough. That's out of bounds once again off the Pilots. Pilots go down 4-2. Another serve by Leah Rose. Called out of bounds, and rightfully so. That's pushed long by Leah. One of the first serving errors we've seen all night from her. Haley Brown now back onto the court. Erin Carlos leading the team in aces. Been very solid server all night. See what she can do now. Carlos with the serve. Pilots down by 1 in set number 3. Short service from Carlos. Huge hit there. That's going to be off the shoulder of Peyton Anderson. Bridget running to go get that. Not fast enough. Point for the Cougars. They're now up by 2 points. Service now from McKay Heasley, the sophomore. Bridget with the dig. That's going to be a double hit called against Peyton Anderson. Haley Brown was there for the hit, but point for the Cougars. Once again, another small mistake, but a costly one for your Pilots. Service once again by McKay Easley. Cassie Sears pushes it long and out of bounds. Point for the Cougars. That's going to be a timeout now from Coach Wiegand. It's all smiles on that Cougar side, and on the Pilot side, frustration for your Pilots. Not a terrible start for Bethel. Yeah, they've been fairly positive so far in this game. We'll see what they can do now coming out of this timeout. We'll continue to mention timeouts are huge in this game of momentum. It can either kill or help the momentum. Hopefully now for the Pilots, it'll get them something going. As it's been all Spring Arbor in these last couple of sets. They're only up by 4, but it seems like quite a bit more as the momentum has been all Cougars in set number 3. Pilots still in the timeout. Wiegand still believes in them. You just got to make sure that the Pilots still believe in themselves, as this game is not over. They're down but not out. We'll see now what McKay Heasley can do. Service now once again by McKay Heasley. touch over the top there by Haley Brown. Cougars able to deal with it. It's got to go over now for Cassie. That's a solid hit there by number 8, Alyssa Walker. Haven't said her name a whole lot tonight, but that was very impressive. Find the hole in the Pilots defense. Point for the Cougars. Huge hit there from Cassie, finding an open spot right inside that sideline. Point for the Pilots. Katie Easter is coming in for Amanda Brinkman. Katie Easter with the serve. Huge block there from Haley Brown, but that's called out of bounds. Point for the Cougars. Service now, number 10, Annika Stokes. Haley Brown off the short set, but huge block there from that Cougars defense. Payton over the net. That's going to be a net violation called against the visiting Spring Arbor Cougars. Point for your Pilots as Meg Gabbard and Britton come back onto the court. Meg Gabbard up for the serve. Pilots only down by 4, set number 3. Service from Gabbard. That's going to be off the net, kept alive by Gabbard, set by Katie Easter. Britton with the huge hit off the dome of number 9, McKay Heasley, out of bounds. Huge hit there from Britton. Pilots now within 3. Gabbard with a serve just over the net, grazes it slightly. Short touch, Carlos is there. Peyton back stepping, but not able to deal with that one. Frustration now on the Pilot side. Only down by 4, service now once again by Casey Fullis. Dig by Gabbard, set by Easter. Britton, another huge hit. They're now within 3. That's been 2 consecutive kills that the Pilots so desperately needed. Cassandra now onto the court for your Pilots. Haley Brown up to serve. That's been huge there for Britton Carnahan. She didn't have a whole lot of kills early on in this game. She had only 1 in the first set. Katie Easter now deals with that very well. Meg Gabbard with a huge play, kept alive somehow. Peyton sniffing out the short ball. Britton finds that out of bounds. She's there. Well done once again by Britton. That's 3 points in a row because of Britton Carnahan. She's been incredible so far in these last few points. In set number 3, we have Haley Brown with her 2nd serve in a row. And the Pilots getting a little bit of life now as the Cougars are forced to call a timeout. Not what the Cougars wanted to do. They still are up 2-0, sitting in a very comfortable position. But the Pilots with some life. Pilots enjoying it. They're having a little fun. They're all smiles now on this Pilot side. Definitely a little bit of concern there over on the Cougars bench. Not the points they wanted to give to the Pilots. Not really a whole lot of mistakes for the Cougars. But there have been some solid offensive plays from the Pilots. It's going to be a quick timeout for Spring Arbor. Just kind of get them back in check, let them refocus a little bit. They're going to go right out of the huddle. Pilots, though, taking advantage of this timeout. Wiegand getting them fired up. They're loving it, though. They're enjoying it. They're having some fun. They are down 2-0, but this game is not over. Pilots are starting to believe that, too, as they're playing pretty well so far. Coming out of that intermission, they're only down by 2 points. Service once again by Haley Brown. Huge hit there from number 8, Alyssa Walker, the freshman out of Indianapolis. Finds the open gap in the Pilots' defense. Even if there would have been a Pilot player there, I'm not sure she could have dealt with that one. That was huge there. Service once again by the senior, Taylor Johnston. Dig from Payton, set by Easter. Great with another huge hit, but the blockers for Spring Arbor sniff that one out. That's number 13, Maggie Watson, and number 7, Courtney Kaiser, able to find the block there. Good hit from Britton, just not enough. Pilots now down by 4. Carlos with the dig. Short set for Payton, tries to find the open gap, able to do so. Johnston with an acrobatic attempt at a save, not able to come up with it. Brinkman now back on the court. Still no sign of Zoe Wolfenbarger with the head injury we saw middle of the second set. Concerns for her, but the Pilots doing well. Peyton Anderson with the short serve over the top. That's going to be a two-handed slam from Cassandra Williams. Pilots now within 2. That's going to be a service error for Peyton. That's not what the Pilots needed, but they played a few good points there together in a row, doing very well so far in set number 3. Momentum's on their side for sure, as we have number 15, Gabrielle Hilliard, once again up to serve for the visiting Spring Arbor Cougars. Set there from Peyton. That's going to be a miscommunication there between Peyton and Cassandra. Another free point for the Cougars. If the Pilots want to win set number 3, they cannot keep giving away these free points. Service again by Gabrielle. Take by Gabbard. Short set there. Cassandra pushes it over the net. Blockers were there, but not enough. That's a point for your Pilots as Bridget and Cassie come back onto the court. Bridget up to serve. Bridget with a short serve. That's going to be off the hands of Peyton Anderson, out of bounds. Point for the Cougars. Cougars up by 4. If they win this set, this game will be all over. Service again there by Leah. Bridget with the dig, set by Peyton. Over the top by Cassandra. Not enough, though, to beat that Cougar defense. That's going to split the Pilots' defenders. Another point for the visiting Spring Arbor Cougars. Just over the net there from Leah. Amanda Brinkman keeps it alive. Cassie's got to go over. That's going to be pushed wide and out of bounds. Appeals for a touch, but not going to get it. Aaron Carlos once again with the serve. That's a huge block out of Haley Brown and Cassie Sears. Once again, they have been solid tonight in the front line. Haley Brown with another block. Amanda Brinkman there with a short touch. Haley Brown trying to get a point now. Brinkman over the top. That's going to be called against the Cougars. Point now for your Pilots as they are within 2 in set number 3. Once again, Carlos with a solid serve. Touched into the net. That's an error once again against your Pilots, or against the Cougars, excuse me. Pilots within 1. follows with a solid serve. Anderson with the dig. It's going to be a backcourt hit. Anderson with the hit there. Block there from Brinkman and Haley. Unfortunately touched out of bounds. Pilots within two. We see now Zoe is coming out of the locker room. She just seems a bit shaked up with the trainer there. Not sure what her injury is going to be or if she's able to play again. We'll see what happens. Pilots within two. Short set. Haley Brown with the kill, but out of bounds. Unfortunate there for the Pilots side. Now within three. Bridger with the touch. Cassie Sears going over the net. Good dig there from the Cougars. That's going to be a free ball for the Pilots. Getting a free point instead. Pilots now within 2 points as Katie Issa comes back onto the court. Brinkman coming off. Katie Issa with the serve. Pilots within two. That's a huge hit and a huge dig out of Carlos. Cassie Sears with a solid hit. Well done there from the blockers on the Cougars side. Haley Brown with the block. Lands on the Bethel side. That's a point for the Cougars. Now up by three. Just over the net with the serve there. That's going to be a free ball now for Spring Arbor. And a weak hit to Carlos. Set now for Anderson. Anderson with the kill. That's right at the face of Annika Stoats. Not able to bring that one up. That's a point for your Pilots. Meg Gabber back onto the court along with Britt Carnahan. Bridget and Cassie coming out. Meg Gabber with the serve. Pilots within 2 points. That is going to be a Pilots point once again. Pilots are feeling it towards the end of set number three. Now only within 1 point. Pilots have not had the lead the entire set. This could be the moment where they tie it up. Service Gabbard. A lot of movement on that serve. Now it's going to be a free ball coming for the Pilots. Never mind. That's Leah Rose once again. She's been solid all night, finding the open gap in the Pilots' defense. Cougars up by two. Short set for Brayton. Excuse me, for Peyton. Huge hit there. That's going to be touched and out of bounds. Not able to deal with it. Point for the Pilots. Now within one. Three-point now coming for the Pilots. Huge hit out of Cassandra. Britton's got to go over now. That's pushed into the face of number nine, McKay Weasley, and that's a point for your Pilots. Tied ball game now at 20 apiece in set number three. Pilots within 5 points of taking set number three and pushing this into a fourth set. That is not what they needed as Haley is frustrated with that service error. Three-point for the Cougars. Service now out at Johnston. Good touch there from Peyton. Free ball now coming for the Pilots side. Brayton with a huge hit there. That's a kill they needed. Tied ball game, 21-21. Fans coming alive now in set number three. Definitely a point they've needed, and Brayton has been solid in this set. She's had some huge kills that the Pilots have needed at the right moments. Brinkman now back on for your Pilots. Peyton Anderson up to serve. Service from Peyton, a sky ball. Brinkman with the block. That's huge out of the senior. Coming on for the Pilots, getting a block, getting a point they so desperately needed, and a timeout now from Spring Arbor. The Pilots are feeling it. They're having a blast. Solid service from Peyton, and an even bigger block out of the senior, Amanda Brinkman. We mentioned before Zoe Wolfenbarger with that injury, not able to come back into the game yet, but the other senior, Amanda Brinkman, coming up clutch for your Pilots. They're having a lot of fun now. Momentum is all on the Pilots' side. Whereas the Cougars, you can see over on their bench, they're all serious. The coach is trying to get them back into this game. They're telling them that they're up 2-0, sure, but you do not want to give the Pilots any bit of hope, and it is definitely hope that is on that Pilot side. Cougars have got to put this thing away, or it could be rough win for Spring Arbor. We'll see what the Pilots can do now. It's set number three. They're only up by 1 point. They are within three of taking this third set. This game is by no means over, nor is the set. It's been very solid both ways on either team. There's been some solid kills and some great serves from both sides now. But Pilots are having a whole lot of fun now. Momentum is all on their side after that huge block out of the senior, who wasn't even supposed to play tonight. She didn't even dress for the first couple of sets, and she comes out of that intermission with the jersey on, and she was definitely a good call there. As we have Peyton Anderson up to serve once again. Service from Peyton. Short serve. Good block there out of the Pilots. Touch over the top from Cassandra, kept alive by Britton. Britton with a touch in the corner, sniffed out there from the Spring Arbor side. Gathered with the dig. Britton's got to touch it over the top, touched by Spring Arbor. Britton with a huge point, but that's going to be out of bounds. Tried to find the open corner, it was open. She was off by just a few inches. Called wide and long by the side judges, as we have once again Gabrielle Hilliard up to serve for the visiting Spring Arbor Cougars. Tied ball game 22 apiece in set number three. Short set there. Cassandra tries to find the backcourt, not able to do so. Touch there. Unfortunate play by the Pilots. The block was there. Just couldn't keep it alive. Pilots down by one. Need this next point. Service once again by Hilliard. Take by Brinkman. Cassandra going over the net, somehow sneaks over. That's somehow kept alive off the block. Gabbard's got to go over. Free point now coming for the Cougars. Gabbard was there, but she was not able to keep that one alive. It is now game point for the Cougars. Rochelle Wiggins going to call a timeout. Gabbard was definitely there. She just couldn't quite get around that. Couple of miscues on the line there for the Pilots as they're unable to come up with a couple of blocks. Can't keep it alive. Pilots are down by two. Cougars are within 1 point of winning this game and taking it 3-0. But the Pilots know they're not out of this one. You can hear there's yelling and screaming on the Cougars side. They're ready to go. They're pumped up. They only need 1 point left. Pilots know they're not out of it yet, though. They've been playing very well in this third set. The game is by no means over yet. They just got to be solid on defense, get 1 point at a time. But if they do give up that 1 point, that one simple mistake, it's going to be game over. And as far as limiting the mistakes, it's been pretty solid so far in the third set. First couple of sets, Pilots have had quite a few simple mistakes that led to some free points for the Cougars, but in set number three, the Pilots have limited those mistakes, and that is definitely shown in the scoreline so far. Hilliard once again with the serve. This is game point. Pilots defense have to come up huge. Gabbard with the dig. Peyton with the set, and that's going to be once again Britton Carnahan with the kill. That's huge. Cassie Sears back on the court along with Bridget. Bridget up to serve. And Britton Carnahan has been the name I've called way too many times in this set number three. She's been on fire with several several solid kills now. Defense has got to be clutch. Huge block out of the senior, Amanda Brinkman. That's blocked and inbounds on the Cougars' side. That is two blocks out of Brinkman, not even supposed to play tonight. She's got one good arm, and she's coming up with blocks that the Pilots so desperately needed. It is win by two, ladies and gentlemen, so the Pilots have to get 2 points to put this away. Brinkman with the dig there. Cassie Sears with the kill. That's going to find its way inbounds. Pilots up 25-24. And just like that, it is game points for your Pilots. What they've done well so far, they haven't freaked out. They haven't realized that, oh, it's game point for their team. They played some solid volleyball. They are now 1 point away from taking it to set number four. Aaron Carlos keeps it alive. Bridget's got to get that over the net. Defense for the Pilots now have to come up huge. Short set there. Carlos with the dig. Set coming here for Cassie Sears. She's going to put it over the net. Huge block once again from the Pilots' front line. That's got to go over from Brinkman. She's going to touch over the net with that bad right arm. Cassie Sears with the hit. Block once again from the Pilots, but that's not going to be enough. Tied ball game once again, 25-25. You saw Brinkman once again favoring that left arm as she's had a constant injury this entire season. Not supposed to play tonight, but she's shown up big with a couple of huge blocks. Service once again from Leah. That's got to be Carlos. That's got to be over the net now. Somehow the Pilots kept that alive. Carlos with a dig. Cassie with the set. 3 point coming for the Cougars. That's another huge block out of Brinkman. That's three in set number three. That's going to be, oh my goodness. The side judge raises her flag to go up and then corrects herself and puts it down. That's a huge point for the Cougars. I thought it was out of bounds, but that line judge calling it in must have just touched that line. It's now a game point for the Cougars. Cassie Sears with the huge kill. She's had a couple of solid plays so far in this set, number three. Haley Brown now back into the game. It's a tied ball game, 26-26 once again. Either team has to win by two now. Carlos up with the serve. Front line solid with the block there. Peyton's got to get the set in. Haley Brown with the kill, but that's sniffed out there by the front line of Spring Arbor. It is now once again game point for the Cougars. Very exciting set number three, but even if the Pilots can pull this one off, they got to win two more sets to win this game. It is now game point once again for Spring Arbor. This has got to go over for Cassie. Cassie Sears has come up clutch in this set number three. That is her third kill when the Pilots so desperately needed her. Brinkman coming out, Katie Easter back onto the court. She's going to be the server. Cassie Sears coming with some huge kills, but she is calm, cool, and collected out there. See what the Pilots can do now. It is a tied ball game. Defense has got to be huge on this point. Huge block there. Unfortunate play. Can't keep it alive. Peyton and Haley Brown were there for the block. Easter and Cassie Sears tried to get the ball up again. Couldn't quite handle it. It is another game point for the visiting Spring Arbor Cougars. Solid service there. Set coming for Haley Brown. Haley's got to get the kill. That's not going to do it. Touch over the top. That's going to be a dig there for Cassie. Haley Brown trying to keep it alive. That's got to be over. Somehow Aaron Carlos keeps it alive. Block there, and that's going to do it, ladies and gentlemen. That's a ball game. Incredible rallies, though, in these last few points as the Pilots keep it alive, showing some life, even being down two sets to zero. Pilots lose the game three sets to zero. They now drop to 5-10 in the Crossroads, 9-19 overall. That is the Spring Arbor Cougars' first Crossroads League win of the season. They improved to 1-15 in the Crossroads and 5-21 overall. Our next Bethel Sports Network coverage is going to be next Wednesday, Bethel versus Marion. That's going to be the last home game of the season. That's November 2nd at 7 p.m. So if you can't make it out to Goodman Gymnasium, we hope to see you once again here on the Bethel Sports Network. I'm Justin Brown, and for Bailey, have a good night, and thank you for tuning in to the Bethel Sports Network.